All right, so I'm back. So now I will be finding the scripture on. I was trying to find it on my own. Let's put that there. Let's see if it fits there. All right, so where was I? I was temple. Okay, so there was something else here. Okay, so put that. All right, so now let's go to temple. Thought there was another scripture that said the temple of the living God. Living God. I thought it was a scripture that said that. Let's see if we get the scripture. First Corinthians 6:19. So it's another one. First Corinthians, that was 3:16 and 6:19. And it says, what? Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, which is in you, which ye have of God, and ye are not your own? Okay, so far I've been saying the living. Okay, so what's this? 1 Corinthians 6. With all the scriptures here. 1 Corinthians 6. And what was it? 19. Okay. All right, let's see if there's another scripture. Ye are the temple of the living God. It does have them and them and walk in them. Okay, this is 2 Corinthians 6:16. 6. Well, I'm smelling some perfume. That's the Fendi. See? When I first put it on, I didn't smell it. Now I'm smelling it. 6. Oh my, yeah. Six and 16 says, and what agreement hath the temple of God with idols? For ye are the temple of the living God. As God has said, I will dwell in them and walk in them, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. So that's where it said, know ye not, nobody say, for ye are the temple of the living God. Okay, so that is 2 Corinthians. Okay, we're going to put that here, temple of God. Continue. And that is, what is it? 2 Corinthians 6:16. 6 and 16. Let's see if there's any more scriptures. I think I got that one already, right? Yeah, I got 1 Corinthians 3 and 16. Yeah, I got that. Okay, so now we gotta go to the arm of God, right? Come get me some money. My eyes jump in. Probably my regular check, but still. All right, so let's. I was looking for the arm of God. Okay, so that's all the scriptures with temple. Temple of the living. Huh? Yeah, I know it is.
What?
I know it is.
I felt like I was an honest people exterminated.
Yeah.
All I knew was the guys. Because I ain't gonna lie, they was coming out places I didn't think they would come out of. Yeah. I'm like, whoa, y'all, the thing on top of the microwave gotta stop on it.
What
the little wooden thing that goes on top, that's the top, they got something on it. Because that's what people they were just doing. They be hiding up, because I didn't know that it had like a little space where they could go in and hide.
Okay.
And when I took that bad boy over, it was
City. Really?
No. That's not on there.
Okay.
All, you know when we go wash the dishes, and you know when we pull out the drawers, and then we push it back, and then it got the space between the counter and the drawer? Oh, I sprayed on it. The corner where the radiator is, where that little pole like that we can't seem to get at to sweep. Whole bunch just came out all out. Somewhere else that I go. It's somewhere else. Underneath the
Don't forget table. The table. I was just gonna say, don't forget that table.
They're probably still dropping right now.
Yeah.
But by the time I finish but all I gotta do, now I'm just putting out the refrigerator and clean the dishes, and then I'm done. And then once I do that, I'm just take off the little break, and then I just got my floor. So I cleaned all underneath the thing where it was like, oh, go under there and clean out.
Okay.
Cleaned underneath there already.
So once you finish cleaning and mopping, then we put down the stuff for them. Don't put it down yet. Once you finish mopping and cleaning the kitchen, then you do a respray, and then you put down the tops with the stuff in.
Gotcha. I'm gonna get this done before Lizzie wake up. Because she's gonna be start begging for stuff, so I need her to read this.
Okay, so now we got that. Move. Yes, she did. All right, so alright, so let me see if I want to find the armor of God myself. You know what, I want to ask something. What was Paul's going inside? Okay, 2 Corinthians. A lot of people say they don't know what Paul's thorn in the side was. I thought it was, I think I read somewhere where it say he had an ailment. He had some sort of ailment. Okay, so we're going to say, it says also, Paul was specific that the thorn in his flesh, our side, was a messenger from Satan. And that's in 2 Corinthians 12 and 7. Let's see. 2 Corinthians 12 and 7 said, and lest I should be exalted above measure through the abundance of the revelations, there was given to me a thorn in the flesh, the messenger of Satan, to buffet me, lest I should be exalted above measure. So now, that's what it said. Okay, so let's go.
You don't have that sorry bottle type. You don't have that small container for soap anymore? The small little Dawn bottle.
No, I think I threw that out when I...
Because I need something small. I don't want to pour that
So just pour half of it in the...
The other one?
Yeah, that's all. That's what I was doing. Okay, so, okay, Theo. It say, although this question is asked from a theological perspective, you know what? I don't know whether I should audio tape this. I think I should audio tape this for videotaping.